Welcome back to H&S Unique Crochet Accessories. Today I'll be making this flora top. Yes, it is this flora top. If you haven't subscribed, remember to like, share, and subscribe to my channel. And you can find me on IG and Facebook. So the materials needed: you need your scissors, your tape measure, and a 3.7 hook. And you will need some yarns. So you can make a magic ring. To make the magic ring, you wrap the yarn around your finger twice, put the hook under, pull up the loop, and then you pull through the loop. That is a magic ring. Also, I'm going to do the chain 5. So you make a slip knot first. So you make a slip knot. And then you're going to put the hook through. Then you're going to chain 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then you're going to make a slip stitch in the first stitch. So you make a slip stitch. And then you're going to chain 3. That's chain 3. Is our first double crochet. Then we're gonna make 11 more double crochet in the center of our circle. So you make 11 more double crochet, so you need 12 double crochet. So you need 12 double crochet. At the end, you are going to count 3 chains up and you're going to make a slip stitch to join. Then you're going to chain 3. So you chain 3, which is count as your first double crochet. And in the same stitch, you are going to make another double crochet. So yarn over, put through, pull through 2, pull through 2. In the next stitch, you're going to make 2 double crochet. So you make 2 double crochet in the next stitch. And in each and every stitch, you're going to make 2 double crochet all the way around. At the end, I'll meet you. So at the end, you should have 24 double crochet. And then you'll join in the third chain. You'll join in the third chain. Then you're going to chain 3 and you're going to make another double crochet in the same stitch that the chain 3 is coming from. So you'll make another double crochet. Then you're going to make 1 double crochet in the next stitch. And then 2 double crochet in the next stitch. So you'll make 2 double crochet in the next stitch. So the pattern is, you're going to make 1 double crochet, then, so you're going to do 2 double crochet, then 1 double crochet, 2 double crochet, then 1. At the end, you should have 36 double crochet. And you'll join in the third stitch. Then you're going to chain 3 and you're going to make 1 double crochet in the same stitch. Then you're going to do 1 double crochet in the next stitch. So 1 double crochet in the next stitch. And then 1 double crochet in the next stitch. So the pattern is 2 double crochet in 1 stitch. So that's 2 double crochet in 1 stitch. And then 1 double crochet in the next 2 stitches. So 1 double crochet, then 1 double crochet. So the pattern is 2 double crochet and then 1 double crochet in the next 2 stitches, and you should have 48 double crochet. Then you're going to chain 10. So you're going to chain 10 and you're going to skip 7 stitches, and in the 8th stitch you're going to make a slip stitch. So you're going to skip 7, in the 8th stitch you're going to make a slip stitch, then you'll chain 10 again. So you're going to chain 10, so you'll chain 10, and then in the, you're going to skip 7 stitch, so you're going to skip 7 stitches, and in the 8th stitch you're going to make a slip stitch. And this is the pattern all the way around: 10 chains, skip 7, and a slip stitch in the 8. At the end you'll slip stitch from our first chain that we begin. So you'll make a slip stitch, and then in the chain 10 space you're going to make a single crochet, then a half double crochet, pull through all three, wrap the yarn around, pull through all three, then you're going to make 3 double crochets, and that is wrap the yarn around, pull through 2, then pull through 2. So make 3 double crochet, then you're going to make 2 treble crochets. So you'll wrap the yarn twice, pull it under, then you're going to pull through 2, then pull through 2, then pull through the other 2, and you wrap the yarn twice again, pull through 2, then pull through 2, then pull through the other 2, and that's your treble crochet. Then you're going to do 3 more double crochet, then a half double crochet, and a single crochet, right? So you'll do 3 more double crochet. So you do 3 more double crochet, and then you're going to do 1 half double crochet, and then you're going to do a single crochet. So you're going to reverse the pattern that you start with first, right? So you're going to reverse the pattern, and then you make your single crochet, after which you would make a slip stitch in the slip stitch previous. Then you're going to do the same thing all the way around, so that would be a double crochet, a half double crochet, then 3 double crochet, right? So do it again. So it's a single crochet, then a half double crochet, then you are going to do 3, right? So you do 3 double crochet, then you're going to do 2 treble crochet. Remember, you wrap the yarn twice, so you make the 2 treble crochet, and then you'll reverse it and continue doing 3 double crochet, then a half double crochet, single crochet, and then you would slip through, and you do this all the way around until you reach the end. Then you'll just chain 1 and cut your yarn off, and you will need 2 of these identical. Okay, so you need 2 of these identical. Alright, so we're going to make the strap that will be tied around your neck. So in between those 2 treble crochet, you're going to make a slip knot. You're going to put the hook in between, and then you're going to pull through between those 2 treble crochet. Then you're going to chain 3, and right where the you make the slip knot, you're going to make a double crochet, right? And then you chain 3 again, and you'll put the hook through the center of the first one that you make right there, and you're going to make a double crochet, and you will continue until you get the length. So it's chain 3 and then make a double crochet. Right, so make a double crochet. They'll continue until you get the length. I'll let you know how much I did. So I did 40 of those, right? And for the same, you're going to do the two straps. So here I finish all two of them. So I'm going to join these now together. So I totally forget, but you need stitch markers, right? So I am going to go back right there where we made the strap, and I'm going to make a slip knot, and I am going to make a chain that is long enough or wide enough that when you put the bra on, it has a space in the chest. So what I did 25 chains. When I measure it, you'll have at least 4 inches, and then I'll just connect it to the other side where you made the strap, and you'll just make a slip stitch there, and then you chain one, cut the yarn off. So that's how we'll join the first piece. Then you're gonna mark it. So because we did 25, so you know you do 11, you do 12, and then in the 13, you know that's the center. So we'll find the center of those 25 chains. Now in the next petal, in between the two treble crochet, we are going to make another chain, which I did 8 chains. So I make 8 chains. After making those 8 chain, I'm going to make a triple crochet in the center where we have marked the first. So you make a triple crochet, right? So right in the center, you'll make a triple crochet, and triple crochet, yarn over twice, pull through two, pull through two, then pull through two. Then I'll make 8 chains, and on the second petal of the next bra cup, I am going to go right between the two triple crochet and make a slip stitch, cut the yarn off, and I'm going to do for the third petal. So you'll make a chain. So I'll make a chain of 8 again, and right in the center where we made that triple crochet the previous row, we are going to do a triple crochet, and then we'll chain 8 and then do another slip stitch in the next petal. So the first petal that you made to put the strap around your neck, you're going to use the next two petals also that comes right after. And then I'll make a slip stitch right there in the center, right? So I'll make a slip stitch right there in the center, and I'll chain one and then cut the yarn. So this is how it should look. This is how. So we have joined it. That's the chest area. And we have 3 petals left. So these 2 petals we are going to join to make the under the bust, right? So I'm going to make a chain. So I'll make a chain of 20. So I'll make a chain of 20. It depends on the size. I'm making a size small to medium. So I'll make a chain of 20. So right there, the 2 petals. At the first petal, I am going to make a double crochet. So right in the center, I am going to make a double crochet. Then after which, I am going to chain 12. And after making the 12 chains, I am going to make another double crochet, not a single, but a double crochet right there. Then I'm going to chain 12 and I'm going to jump right over on the next cup, and on that petal I'm going to make a double crochet. Then I'm going to chain 12 and make another double crochet. So I'll make another double crochet, after which I'm going to chain 20, because on the first side we made 20 chains. So I'm going to make 20 chain plus 3 more, right? And then I'm going to double crochet in the fourth chain from the hook, right? So I'll make the fourth chain from the hook, and then we'll continue making double crochet all the way across to the end. So you're going to make double crochet all the way across until you reach the end. When you reach, so that's when you reach the end, you will chain four, turn your work, and you're going to skip one chain, and you're going to make a double crochet. So the chain four there is a double crochet plus a chain one. So you're going to chain one and you're going to skip one stitch and double crochet into the next stitch. And this is the pattern all the way down. When you reach to the end, if you want to cut off, you can cut off there, but I'm going to make another. So ensure that you find the last stitch there at the end and you make your last double crochet. Then you're gonna chain up four, turn your work again, and then you're going to make a double crochet on the previous double crochet, right? You're going to chain one, make a double crochet on the previous double crochet, and you will continue that pattern all the way down. When you reach the end, you would chain one and cut your yarn off. So all the way down. Or if you want to make more rows, you can go ahead and do so. So there I finish, cut my yarn off, and this is how it is. Now we're going to join right where you have the petal first there. You're going to count off 4 stitches away, and you're going to mark those 4 stitches away from this petal. Then on this petal, the third one that we did the joining, away from the treble crochet, you're going to count 3 stitches away. Right there, you would make a slip knot. So you'll make a slip knot to join, and you would secure it. Then you wrap the yarn around right where you make the first stitch mark. You're going to make a double crochet in that first stitch marker. So you remove the stitch marker and you'll make a double crochet. Then you will continue making double crochet all the way down until you reach your next stitch marker, right? So you'll make the double crochet all the way down until you reach your next stitch marker. So here at your next stitch marker, you're going to make your last double crochet. So I'll just remove the stitch marker there and I'll make the last double crochet. Then you're going to make another double crochet right from the petals that we did the joining first. So remember, count 3 chains from the treble crochet and you'll make a double crochet right there. Then you're going to chain 2, turn your work around, and we are going to do decrease. So you'll wrap the yarn around, insert the hook in the first chain, pull up a yarn, pull through 2, then wrap the yarn around, pull up the yarn, pull through 2. You'll have 3 chains, then you go through all. Then you're gonna continue making double crochet until you have the last two stitches right there. You'll do the same, wrap the yarn around, pull through two, then wrap the yarn around, not completing the double crochet, pull through two, then you're going to pull through all three loops and that's your decrease. Then you're going to chain two and you're going to decrease again. So to do the decrease one more time, you're going to wrap the yarn around, put through the stitch, sorry about that, then you're going to pull, put the yarn around, pull through two, then pull, wrap the yarn around, pull through two, should have three stitches, then you make another decrease. So you'll make another decrease, right? So do that and make another and pull through all. So you're supposed to have one stitch, then you're going to wrap the yarn around. You are going to join in the center that we did the triple crochet while we were joining the petals. So right there, you would just turn the work so you're able to do that, and you'll make a double crochet. So after making the double crochet, you'll just slip stitch, you'll just make a slip stitch to secure, chain one and cut the yarn off. So right there, you complete joining the middle and you have your strap. So this is how it should. So this is the finished look, but here there's one petal that is not joined. What I decide is to make a chain and to join that petal. This is the back view of it, and I decide to join a chain. Just you can join it at the back or you can put it right at the side. So what I did was to go in between the two treble crochet and I joined there, making a chain of 15. Then I count off 10 stitches away, and in the 11th stitch, depending on your size, I'll mark that. So I'll mark my 11th stitch and I'll do that for both sides. After chaining 15, I'm going to make a double crochet to join. So I'll just make a double crochet. Alright, so if you choose not, you don't have to put the strap there, but just make a double crochet, chain one, cut the yarn off. So what you do on one side, you do on the other side, and then you lock your threads in after locking your thread. This is it, guys, my Flora top. Thank you so much for watching my channel. Remember to like, share, and subscribe. And if you have gone ahead and made this Flora top, you can send me pictures to my Instagram page or right here on my YouTube page. Thank you so much.